Hey, what's up, guys? This is AJ, and in this current series, we are discussing about Indian polity. In this lecture, we will discuss about the Finance Commission. See, Finance Commission is a constitutional body. The Article 280 deals with the construction of the Finance Commission. It is a quasi-judicial body. Some judiciary power is appointed or given to the Finance Commission. Okay, and then constituted by the President at every 5 year. Or as such earlier as he considers. Okay, so President creates or constitutes the Finance Commission for 5 years, and he also dissolved that Finance Commission earlier before the completion of its tenure. Okay, then the third thing is that composition of the Finance Commission. Finance Commission consists of 5 members. One is a chairman and 4 are other members. These are appointed by the president. Okay, they are eligible for reappointment, and constitution authorizes parliament to determine the qualification of members and their selection process. Okay, so the who will be members of the Finance Commission, what will be their qualification, what will be their work experience to consider them as a member of Finance Commission is decided by, or the decision is taken by, the parliament, not by the president. President just appoints them. Okay, then the chairman of the Finance Commission should have experience in public affairs. Okay, otherwise he will not be selected as a chairman of a Finance Commission. Then there are 4 members of Finance Commission. One must be the judge of High Court, or the one who is eligible to become the judge of High Court. Okay, so he will handle some legal technical things in the Finance Commission. Okay, and all other 3 are must be related with the finance, that the all 3 members remaining must have done something related to the finance. Okay, so they may be have some special knowledge about the finance and accounts of government. They must have some wide experience in financial matters and in administration. And then one of the members should have special knowledge of economics. Okay, so if these conditions are satisfied, then the Finance Commission is or the members will be eligible to become the member of Finance Commission. Then what are the functions of Finance Commission? See, the Finance Commission is an advisory body. It does not take some decision. It just recommends something to the Government of India. Okay, so what it first of all it recommends the distribution of taxes among the state. Okay, so how much percentage of taxes, collection of taxes collected by the federal government should be given to the state is decided by the Finance Commission. Means what? Finance Commission recommends the percentage of tax revenue to be given to the state. Then it again recommends the principle that should govern grants in aid to the state by center. Okay, so we know that center gives grants to the states. Okay, so what it Finance Commission recommends the formula for giving the grants in aids to a particular state as per the state's qualification. Okay, then it measures we know that in panchayatis and in municipalities the president may appoint a Finance Commission to to recommend something to these municipalities and to these panchayats. Okay, so if there if we want to implement those recommendation, then what measures should be taken by the state government to implement the you know, the ideas of the Finance Commission to the implement the recommendation of the Finance Commission, because the you know these recommendations are drawn on the Consolidated Fund of India or state. Okay, so we must formulate some formula to retrieve the money from the Consolidated Fund of state to be given to the municipalities and panchayats. This formula is recommended by the Finance Commission, and to implement that formula, the Finance Commission suggests some recommendation, and this must be implemented by the state. Okay, and it also does a job appointed by the President of India in any matter related with the finance. Okay, then there are some other functions like Commission submits its report to the President. Okay, we have seen that Attorney General of India also submits its Comptroller and Auditor General of India submits its three reports to the President. In the same manner, Finance Commission of India is also submits a report to the President. Okay, then though is a Finance Commission is a advisory body, though it is constructed by the Constitution or its constitutional body, legal body, but they only recommend. There is no compulsion on the government to implement the recommendations of the Finance Commission, but most of the time they implement those recommendation. Okay, then there is a fight between the Finance Commission and Planning Commission. See, the fight is because the Planning Commission does the same job as a Finance Commission, but government is tend to accept the recommendation of the Planning Commission instead of Finance Commission, though the Planning Commission is not a constituted or a statutory body. They most of the time follows the recommendation of the Planning Commission, so member of the Finance Commission are not in good mood, because the Constitution explains the Finance Commission as a balancing wheel of fiscal federalism, but in reality it is not applicable. So most of the time these members are angry with the government, but now we know that Finance Commission, Planning Commission is no more, so I guess they will be happy with the decision of the Modi government. So thanks guys for watching this video, and I will meet you guys in my next video. Peace.